Right. Mukiona hivi nimesha furahi because today ni kama I have been taken home. Leo it's all about fish, but ile fish imeenda shule. You know the regular thing you're used to. Ile imeenda shule. So today we're going to be making something very interesting. A very good morning. Wacha niwasalimie kwanza, wherever you are. As Kenyans, we always have to start there. Habari yenu. I hope you're well. Karibu sana in the kitchen as we start cooking and getting you warmed up for the weekend. And I hope, by the way, if you have been an ardent viewer of this particular show, like me, I was sharing with my guest this morning. I mean, my cooking skills have just begun to... These days I'm showing off. And I hope that wherever you are, at least you may learn 1, 2, 3 things. And you can suggest what you want us to cook. You can suggest who you want us to have on board. By the way, it's all about you. Let's have fun. Let's all learn together. And in studio this morning, I am having another chef expert. He's not a new face on the show. Tumekuwa naye here before, always coming prepared. Mnaweza ona set vile inaka. Alisema he's not joking, he's serious. He knows his stuff and he's here. He's from Parkin by Radisson. Hapo tu Westlands, yeah?
Hapo Westlands, yes.
Anaitwa Alfan. Kuna jina lingine lakini mimi hiyo Alfan ndo napenda.
Alfan iko sawa. I'll go by your name.
Mohamud. Karibu sana.
Asante sana.
Yeah, good to see you.
Thank you so much.
How is your Thursday? How is your week?
My week is so nice.
Awesome.
Yes.
How's your year been? Najua tumefika hiyo season ya kuuliza
mwaka imekuwaje. Mwaka imekuwa poa. Yes, that's one thing.
Tuambia nini imekuwa mzuri. Leo unatupikia samaki. Lakini you have a name for it.
Yes.
So, hebu tell us.
So the name is called Oat-Crusted Red Snapper.
Umesikia?
Ni ngumu hiyo.
Oat-Crusted Red Snapper.
Yes.
Andika hiyo mahali. That's what you are making.
So basically oats ni ile tu ile ya uji. Ile ya uji.
And then
Yes, so the basically the new we're going to use today, the method, we call it F for flour, E for egg, then O for oats. So that would be fail, right? It's fail.
Fowl.
Is it fowl?
At the eggs, fail. Yeah.
Isn't fail? Yes, fail.
So
F-E-O. There's other one we use, normally we call it Feb. Feb is flour, egg, breadcrumb.
Ah.
So you get that one.
Ah,
when you're doing that
that
ka chicken.
Ah,
you're
okay.
Breadcrumb, yeah?
Ah.
So today you're using oats instead of...
Did you know you can use oats instead of breadcrumbs?
So today
we're
going to use...
I'm going to show you how.
Exactly.
Hey, but usituchanganye sana.
Pole. So here goes our snapper. Uh-huh. It's a fillet. Mm-hmm. Doesn't have any bone. So for you can use still tilapia, ngege, mbuta.
Mbuta.
Yeah.
The one. Mbuta inakuanga.
Yeah, you can make it flavor out of it. The aroma is so strong.
Kila mtu anaishi hapo atajua.
Atajua tu kuna mtu anakula kambuta pahali. So you just portion your tilapia.
So mine I'm using any fish that has fillet.
Yes, any fish that has fillet can work.
Because kuna nyingine. So kuna nyingine inaitwa mgongo wazi.
Don't
try that.
But iko na inaonga na miba, si ndio?
Lakini haina fillet mzuri.
Haina fillet mzuri?
Yeah.
But iko na miba.
Yeah.
Eish. Hiyo hapa unaweza nyongo bwana. Can choke you.
Yeah.
So we start with our 2 portion, as you can see, that's the size. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So there's something about making it thin.
Yes.
It has to be like the slice, like it was thin kidogo
ndio. Inaweza kuwa this big.
If you
But if you're using it you kishai crust vizuri, you can put on the oven. You pan sear a bit then you put on the oven.
Okay.
But for us today we're going to cook it to the pan.
Okay.
Yes. There are some people don't have that the oven on their houses.
Yes, yes.
They can still do like how we're going to do today.
All right.
Yes.
All right.
So after cutting, now it's time to marinate first. So we marinate, basically you can do the herbs. These are dry herbs.
Mm-hmm.
So
this is just like a mixture.
Just a
of
mixture.
What?
Yes,
rosemary
yes. Rosemary ko hapa. Kathyme kadogo. Some mint.
Mm-hmm.
But it's good for flavors. Then some salt, just a pinch.
Mm-hmm.
It's a good pinch. So you flavor a bit, some mustard.
All right, just a minute. Let me do this, yeah?
So that they can see.
So that they can see, yeah?
Okay.
You want to be alone.
Yes.
There.
So here, basically, we have some mustard.
All right.
So you put your master there. Then some salt is here. This salt I've mixed with paprika.
Yeah, I was about to ask, why is your salt red, guys? This is salt.
Yes, that is salt. So
it's red, but yes. Now he's explaining he has mixed it with paprika.
With paprika, he mixed with paprika a bit. Then here is fish sauce. It's like light soy sauce, but it's for fish.
Mm.
So just put a bit there. Easy peasy.
All right.
Then after that, just a pinch of, how do you call it?
Apple and potato.
Cumin.
Oh, I'm used to the cumin powder.
Yes.
So this is like kile ida ijapo crushed.
So that you can give it more flavor. Just a kadogo to jina kwanga strong.
Ah, okay.
It's a bit strong, so you just kadogo. Very small. So okay. To look like something like that.
All right.
See? So well marinated,
so this is marination,
seasoned.
Yeah?
Yes. Then just black pepper.
Black pepper kidogo tu.
Kidogo tu.
Kidogo tu.
Yes.
There you,
then you turn like that. So remember our method.
All right.
Remember our method.
Yes, I remember.
Yes.
So, but must it be like step by step?
Yes, step by step. It must go like that.
Okay,
no, as in for this one, it's not supposed to be like a step. For marination, you mix. That is fine.
It depends.
Depends.
When you two men,
yes.
When you
two men,
I was asking. Lazima niende step by step.
No. So nakama if you are at home and you don't have these spices of mine, like all of them, just use the basic one.
What
just salt.
Have.
Salt is enough.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
You can add those other things if you have, yes. But if you don't have, salt is enough for it, right?
The fish sauce. What if you don't have that? You have.
You can still.
The soy sauce.
You can still. Yeah. Light soy sauce, but not
light
dark.
Light soy sauce. Oh.
But
okay.
Not dark.
Okay.
If you use dark, it will turn the color.
Ah, okay.
Yes. So, then some lemon. You can either squeeze, but mine I've already done the nini. I've already squeezed it on a bottle.
Mm-hmm.
So just put a bit of it to give it some acidity. So you mix. Remember our method?
Yes.
The
fail.
The fail. So you start with flour first. So you dust well. So after dusting, dust very well to ensure that there's no water which has passed through.
All right.
Then you dip on your egg. Again, use on the same.
All right. So you don't have to let it sit for maybe a few minutes.
No.
Won't be.
For fish is our white meat, and it really absorbs very fast the marination.
Okay.
So like a red meat.
Okay.
Yes. So if you put it for long, it will become more salty.
Okay.
Yes.
So hata ukiwa na haraka, if you are in a hurry, this can be a very good option for you.
Yes. So you put on your egg like that. It's easy.
It is very easy.
So,
So
wana
kuna kizungu mingi. Hakuna kizungu mingi na procedures mingi.
Yes. So after hapo,
yeah.
You just put on your
apart pot. From the spices, but you said it's optional.
It's optional.
If you don't have all the things that he has used, you can just use what you have.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So after dipping on your egg, now you put on your oats. After that, you're okay.
Mm. Umetufunza kitu feo.
Feo, yes.
Nakuna feb.
Nakuna feb.
Ah.
So feb, niyo natumia?
Breadcrumbs.
Breadcrumbs. Thank
right.
you.
So we are to the oats
you are now. You're a good student. Mimi kama sana kuweka jikoni.
Si ndio?
Nikawa kuja kitchen yangu sasa.
I should.
Yeah, you should.
Kuje sasa kwa kwenye everything inatoka.
Yes.
Mm.
So after hapo, you see, you just crust it. But you can still toss your oats a bit. You toss on a pan.
Mm-hmm.
Then you put some salt on it to give it more flavor.
To give it flavor.
Yes.
Ah, okay.
So you toss. Yeah, you can even still put some herbs if you feel like.
Mm-hmm.
But mine, I'm just doing it basic so that everyone can do it at home.
All right. There. So you have to ensure all the
all
parts are well covered.
Well covered with oats.
Okay. There you go.
You see, it's easy.
Very easy. You make it look easy.
So easy. You can
wait until people try it. They always challenge you guys.
Yeah.
Whatever we are making here, you try make it at home, and then we'll pick a picture.
Yes.
Right
kind.
Now, you share with us on social media. We
yes.
see it was one of those moments of what you ordered versus what you got.
actually, funny enough,
Yeah.
This thing is on our menu. mm-hmm. on our new menu.
Ah, okay.
We are launching our new menu at Parkin by Radisson. Mm-hmm. Please come and visit and see these things. They're there.
Okay, so these are new things you're trying
they're new things.
Spice up.
Yeah, to spice up.
Play around with the test buds.
With the test buds, yeah, what?
Ah, okay.
Yeah, so you should... She'll be, actually, you're supposed to come. What happened? Speak of Nimechoma. Nimechoma.
Mambo ni mengi. Mambo ni mengi.
Mambo ni mengi.
Sikuntakuja, siji mtafunga because now.
Tutakuja full force. Ah, tutakuwa tuko ready mbaya.
Hizi vitu umenionyesha hapa kwa show. Yeah. Hey, I'll want to taste each and every one of them.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So you see? Easy.
All right.
So wow. After that... Now we go to our next step.
Yeah, you see this? I mean, wacha kupika samaki the regular way. Look at this. Eh? Umezoea tu wet fry. You know, do something different. I mean, be creative kidogo kwa kitchen. There you go. So, yeah. So this is almost ready to go
almost,
in the pan.
It's ready to go to the pan. Uh-huh. Then after that, we go to our next step of doing roasty potatoes.
Ah, awesome.
You know roasty potatoes?
Today you'll know. Yeah.
So we're doing our roasty potatoes.
So we do that now or we're still going on with the fish?
We're still going with the fish while you're doing our roasty potatoes.
All right. So multitasking.
We multitask.
Ah, okay.
So, roasty potato, first thing you do, you grate your potatoes. Mm-hmm. Just grating, yeah? Now after grating, you strain the water. Mm-hmm. See the excess water.
So the waru or the which ones?
The waru.
Okay.
Waru just plain like this. You see, I've grated them, mm-hmm. as you can see.
Ah, okay.
Yes, so you just strain. I'm having a conical strainer here. Uh-huh. You can use kichungi, like the normal.
You have.
The normal kichungi.
The one you have.
Yes.
Mm. Uyu ni chef. Uyu ni yako level ingine. So don't compete with him. He has the tools of trade.
Yeah,
tools of trade. But I always like how you simplify things for our viewers.
Yeah.
If you don't have this.
Yeah, you use this. Yeah.
Yeah.
So you can use kichungi.
Don't be discouraged.
Yeah. Because something like this getting outside is tricky. Yeah.
So we're even just thinking of buying.
Thinking of buying such thing.
Yeah.
For me, I know why I'm using it. Mm. Yeah. Because it's like fundi akose nyundo.
Imagine.
So after that, you see, those are potatoes. They're just grated.
All right.
Easy. Now, next step.
I told you he's extra. Mwazoya tu kutoa kupil, una slice, mawaru. Lakini tusiguze murima.
Tusiguze murima.
Tuguze
murima.
Tuende pole.
So after that, our salt. Just a good pinch. Why do we use paprika salt? Because it brings more flavor, mm-hmm. brings a nice color, mm-hmm. as you can see.
Yeah. The touch of red.
The touch of red. So nice, eh?
Okay.
Then after that, some pepper. Always pepper and salt goes well. Mm-hmm. We ni bibi na bwana. They love each other a lot, eh?
Eh, unani alikwambia bibi na bwana wote, they go well.
Where? Tusiende hapo. Usiguze mlima.
Usiguze mlima.
Usiguze mlima.
Chef, you love what you do, right?
I love what I do,
actually. It gives you, does it give you like the satisfaction? How do you feel when?
When I can cook, like, even, I don't know, Michelle Sasabe Usiku.
Oh, really?
Chef, wake up and cook. I'll start cook. This is my job.
Awesome.
Yes.
Mm.
So,
onions?
Put some onions. Then you mix a bit. After that, some natural yogurt. Kadogo tu.
So far, it looks complicated, but so far, guys, bedeni. Potatoes too.
Potatoes.
Salt, yeniko na paprika.
Yes.
Onions, and natural yogurt.
Yes.
So nothing out of the ordinary.
You can still use your herbs. For me, I'll just use my small herbs, mm-hmm. give it a bit more flavor.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Mix a bit.
Spicy. What I've loved about what you're doing, kidogo, kila kitu.
Kidogo.
Usi overdo.
Unenda overboard.
Baka unapoteza testi ya the food.
The food, yeah.
Making. Sasa you're just testing. What you're getting is just the spices.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So after that, kamayai.
Mm.
Yes. See? That's our egg. That's kadogo tu.
Ah, okay. So the salt, has it been seasoned or it's plain?
Which one? The egg is the just eggs. Plain. It's just plain. It's just plain egg. Then unga, flour, just a bit. Mm-hmm. Then you mix.
Okay. So this is for breakfast.
This is you can eat
break. Dinner or where?
Actually, this one you can eat breakfast. Mm-hmm. You can eat at lunch and at dinner. Because it's an easy.
To me, like breakfast.
Breakfast, not like a breakfast. You can see that you have to breakfast.
Yeah.
So you see, it's easy.
Or lunch.
Or lunch, yeah. Mm. Nice.
Hey, dinner, po.
Is that unaki mzito? Amani mzito sana. Mzito for dinner, eh?
Yeah.
Amani light.
Hey, apana. For me, it's okay. Lakini najua timo.
Hey, timo mbaka ikuwe na
sembe. Apo kuna shida.
Mbaka ikuwe na sembe.
Lazima kuna ugali.
Lazima ikuwe na sembe pahali. So, we're having some olive oil. Mm-hmm. So we put on our pan. Inaweza kubabula up.
Inaweza kuleta shida.
So easy.
Lakini umezoea mafuta. Mwili umeungua hadi.
Mwili umeungua hadi sasa hata. Some butter.
All right. What's the difference? Oil, butter, like
butter has,
what do you achieve when you...
When you use butter, it has some more flavor.
Ah, okay.
Yes. See the flavor. You see, unanga butter is expensive kuliko mafuta. Yes.
Oh, because yeah, ina leta ladha ingine.
Ladha ingine tofauti.
Ah.
So we put our fish there. Then you just give it some time.
Mm-hmm.
So you can still put your herbs. Kuipansia vizuri, mm-hmm. Kuna more flavor.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That is normal for bubbling.
Let it pan fry. Yeah?
And let it pan fry.
So our oats were just plain. We didn't do anything.
But I had about seasoning.
Uh-huh.
I had seasoned it a bit.
Oh, okay.
So you season your oats. You can take a pan like this one. You put your oats, you pan fry,
mm-hmm.
just a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Then you put some salt and herbs if you have.
Without oil, nikama tu.
Without roast. Oil, yeah, nikama una roast. But if you have oven, you just put on your oven tray some salt. If you have some few herbs, do there and then you put on the oven.
Wow.
You let it there for almost like 10 minutes, 20.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Wow.
And this gives a certain color like that, a bit brown.
Mm-hmm.
Becomes easy for you.
All right.
Yes. So while that is continuing, we can be doing our roshti.
Mm-hmm.
So the roshti is basically you are going to pan. You use a pan. So after kidogo, but make sure your pan is a bit hot.
Mm. Roshti potatoes.
Roshti potatoes.
Eish. Unakuanga extra.
Nakuanga extra.
Extra.
Atuwezi pia jinangini.
In a good way.
Yeah, pia jinangini kweli.
Ah.
Ya kikenya.
Apana.
Tuibatize jina.
Unajua chakula pia ndo iku entice kukula. Iyo jina inaweza kuinvite.
Izo majina zake.
Then how it looks, how it will be presented, ita kuinvite.
Ita kuinvite, true.
Lafu now how it tastes.
Thank you.
Eh.
So you see?
Ah, awesome. So this way you ensure it's cooking baka andani.
Baka andani.
Ah, okay.
Yes. You can add some more butter.
But siri wa ni nini? Because sometimes unapata the outer part looks very yummy.
But ndani ijaiva.
You dig in.
Ni kuipea tu more time. Mm-hmm. Na kumake sure check your temperature. Just check your temperature well.
Okay. So unapunguza.
Unapunguza tu moto. Wache tu hive pole pole.
Okay.
Kwa sajua ile joto inaingia ndani.
Okay.
So ikiingia ndani inaiva tu poa.
Okay. Alright.
So make sure you try this at home. Kisha ifanya, tag me. Chef, I did this one. What do you think about it? Yeah? You share, I can give you some more ideas.
Are you sure?
Yes,
watu watakuwekea vitu hapo anyway.
They can do it.
The first, like I always say, the first time may not be perfect.
Yes.
But the second time, the third time, well, you never know. You'll surprise yourself.
Yeah.
Keep trying. These things, you keep trying. And then the good thing about this is that tunaeka hii show YouTube. So kama hauko kitchen saa hii, I mean, you can try it
every
time
yeah.
and see how it turns out. Pick a picture, tag us so that we see what you made.
Thank you.
All right.
So make sure they visit Pakin, they see what we are offering there.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Because we have a lot. We have a lot there. Mm-hmm. Yes. So this is how we do our roshti. Ni kama tu unafanya pancake.
Mm-hmm.
So, can you call it pancake ya viazi?
Pancake ya waru.
Pancake ya waru. Watu wa Nyandarua mko wapi?
And you know one thing about it? I think it's the magic also is the unga and eggs.
And
eggs. Vinafanya inashikana.
Yes. Exactly.
Like sort of like.
Sasa so, unamjua.
Glue them all together.
Sasa unamjua ujanja.
Eh, hiyo ndo ujanja.
So pia next time ujaribu.
Nikutumia picha.
Nimeifanya.
Usijali.
Yeah. Iwe kama Sunday best.
Eh?
Iwe kama Sunday best.
Nakwambia.
So you see?
Looks nice. And the aroma ya fish imeanza
kukamu.
Chachisha huku ndani. Eh? And the herbs.
And the herbs.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. So njaa imeanza mapema.
So, will you do the honor?
Yeah, could cook. Hey, apana. Eish.
Easy.
Where?
I trust you can do it.
You want me to yoko de uko? If I try that, tutaiendea huko.
Ah, tunarokota tu. Magic.
Yeah? Okay.
Or some butter,
I look
more
like
flavor.
A real pancake now.
Yes, nukambia ni pancake. Pancake ya Nyandarua.
Hey. Huh? Ya Kirinyaga. Kirinyaga kuna waru.
Kirinyaga kuna waru, sindo?
I don't know. Watu wa Kirinyaga, mtu ambie.
Kama kuna tuwaru.
Kuna waru. Eh? There.
So you see? So, do the one again.
Ay, apana.
Try. Ah. I trust you. I trust you. Look, look. Easy. One, two, go. You put here.
Do not try this at home.
Nataka have a try.
Nataka kunichomea.
Siwezi. Kuna ngiri utatengeza.
Let me just stick to this side.
So there.
Which, yokota huko chini kwa
yes, if it becomes brown like that,
ah, nice.
It means it's ready.
Nice.
You see?
So it cooks very fast.
It cooks very fast.
Was it 5 minutes?
5 minutes.
Yeah.
Five easy. Minutes. You see?
You have to really regulate your fire.
Yes. So put a bit.
For these ones.
For these ones.
Yeah.
Use low heat to give you more.
Mm. All right.
So make sure all parts are well cooked, mm-hmm. Like that. You can feel how rough it is.
The crunchiness.
The crunchiness.
At least that one I can do.
That one you can do. But ingine ya chef.
Sawa, iko sawa.
Iko fiti?
Iko fiti. Then umepunguza moto kabisa, so inaiva pole pole.
Inaiva pole pole.
I always like also asking the nutritional value of whatever it is that we are making.
Yes.
And I want to say, people are living healthy, people are counting calories.
So you see oats.
Eat akupatia nini in terms
you,
of,
you see
apart
oats,
from the flavor.
Apart from flavor, you see oats is one of the, how do you call it, recommendation from the doctors.
Uh-huh.
You take oat porridge, you get, because it brings you good vitamins,
mm-hmm.
and other stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you've made your oats, and the protein of fish,
mm-hmm.
all together.
Mm-hmm.
So you've gained a lot of nutrition value,
mm-hmm.
out of it.
Mm-hmm.
So I suggest, I always say, don't just eat the oats just by itself, like all the day.
Mm-hmm.
Today I'm having oat porridge,
mm-hmm.
oat porridge tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Tomorrow I'm having semolina porridge. At least now you can make your
protein
out of that. You get something good.
There's egg also.
There's egg also there.
Okay.
Yes. Mm. On top of that, you have the herbs, which they are good too.
Ah,
they're
okay.
Just natural.
Yeah, true.
Yes.
True.
No more spices, just easy.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Alright. Tukupia, tuko sawa.
Tuko Nyandarua. So.
Upenda watu wa Nyandarua. Utatuambia ulienda Nyandarua.
Ulienda Nyandarua lini sio?
Yeah.
So we check our fish.
Oh, okay. It's time. Sorry.
It's time to cut.
Yeah.
So, there you go.
Fish.
See?
Yeah, I'm even done.
Yes. You can still put a bit.
Mm. Just to make sure it's well cooked.
It's well cooked.
At least by now you know I'm team well cooked, eh?
Team well cooked, yeah.
Kuku kwa medium rare.
Medium rare, sijui.
Eh, unaletewa kitu ikiwa na, I don't want to say. Labda kuna wenye wanapenda ikiwa hivyo wasa.
Eh, kunayo.
Nimewa discriminate.
Eh.
Pika nyama iive.
Masimanga ni chakula ya wazungu.
Karibu tutaanza kuchinja mnyama na tunamkula tu.
Kiwa mbichi.
Yeah. But they usually say, though I've never tried, but they say there's a different flavor you're missing.
Yes, true. Yeah. They say, this is how chefs say, why would you eat a charcoal? Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Like, well done, they say well done is a charcoal.
Like
umekula charcoal. But let's eat from medium going up. So
I'm still not convinced.
I'm
not convinced.
Answer a medium.
Well cooked.
Next time I'll come. Next time I'll come with a steak.
No,
next time I'll come with a steak. I'll make for you medium. Next time I'll do a medium steak.
I've never tried.
You'll have to try now for me.
No, they say then you are missing.
You're missing.
Yes.
For the flavor, the flavor of meat is there. You can feel. Hey, but then I kula ngombe.
Unasikia hiyo ladha.
It's like unakula ni kama ukule mbuzi alafu mbuzi haina taste. Niko na get. Unaona lakini unasikia si mbuzi bana. Unaelewa?
Challenge me one of these days.
I will. I'll do a steak just for you.
Okay.
And we make it medium just for you, So we'll be doing our plating over here.
Mm-hmm. That side is good.
That side is good.
I'll come this side. I think this side is better.
This side is more better?
It will be more visible.
Okay. So let me remove my pot and other spices. Mm.
Cook as you clean. Cleanliness is next
to godliness.
Yeah. Right. So, Chef, how many years into this?
Uh-huh. 16. Right now it's 16.
16?
Yes.
And, almost 2 decades.
Almost 2 decades. Okay. But still, we want to achieve more.
Are you still finding yourself learning?
Yes. Every day is a learning day.
I'm umefika.
Why bado? Hey, bado mbali.
Trying out new things
and always.
Is this true?
Yes.
Sami, Indo nilisomea. Yeah, cleanliness. You learn every day, yeah?
You learn every day, uh-huh. Yes.
So, what do you do to upate my ideas? Tamutamu kama what you're making today.
Trying out things. So, for me, I always try things which I've never done.
Mm-hmm.
I give challenges to myself and to my students.
Ah, okay.
Because I have so many
students
there.
Yes. Ah, okay.
A lot of them. I train a lot of students.
Uh-huh.
And I always give them challenges at all time, reason being.
Mm-hmm.
I was even challenged one day. So I want them to have the passion for cooking, because cooking is not easy.
Mm-hmm.
Until you have, you should know how to self-drive yourself,
mm-hmm.
first of all.
Mm-hmm.
Doing these things, is not a magic. It's you trying every single day,
mm-hmm.
doing practice all the time,
mm-hmm.
until it comes to your hand.
Mm-hmm.
But if you say, today I'm going to cook, then you start like, pop,
mm-hmm.
it will never come.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
So you have to practice every day. You cook until you make it perfect. Mm-hmm. Yes.
All right.
So we'll be doing.
Where are we going next?
Next, we are doing our vegetables.
Ah, okay.
Yes.
You have to balance your diet.
Exactly.
Yeah. Cheza na kila kitu.
So we have our. How do you call this one? From your language.
Is it broccoli? No.
From
my language.
This.
How do you expect me to know that?
Saba si kizungu leo mzee.
Tofauti na hii ni gani?
Sasa tunataka ndio sasa tuone kama utakomezira danish.
Niambie sasa tofauti.
Sasa hii ni broccoli. Alafu hii?
Hiyo ni gani?
Hii ni cauliflower.
Ah.
So hii haiwezi kushinda.
Hii ni cucumber.
No.
Yake.
That's a gadget.
Ah.
cucumber inakuanga mostly kwa salad. Then if you want to know a cucumber, you see the skin side. See, for this one is soft. Ya cucumber inakuanga dotted.
Ah, okay.
Mostly. Na pia mostly naonga ya kukula. Ah, hii obviously unajua ni carrot. Hii utanishainia.
Mbona unuizi?
Utanishainia.
Mbona unuizi?
Utanambia, chef moa, hiyo ni raisi.
Uh-huh. All right.
We'll saute a bit from the sauce we had there. It has some more flavor. So, pinch of salt.
Mm-hmm. For the vegetables, you can try any.
You can try any. Yeah, you can do any that you feel.
These onions there.
Some onions. These are onion rings. Just for more flavor. Mm. So, but my vegetable, I blanched them a bit earlier. I'd already blanched them with just water alone. Okay. I did not season with anything. Mm-hmm. So there, next, we're going to do our presentation.
Oh, okay. Now
so
we do
easy.
This.
Yes.
Mm. So before even we do our presentation, you're telling me it's been 16 years.
Yes.
I'm just curious, like what did you know then? Something you didn't know,
yes,
that you know now, you know, like you getting into the industry, what has surprised you over the years?
One thing I can say now, by the thanks to Chef Emmanuel Aluda, who has been there to mentor me in terms of cooking, management, like for now I can even stand out,
mm-hmm,
like a chef, reason being, I already know what is in the kitchen, what hotels entail. What it's not all about cooking in a hotel.
Mm-hmm.
It's about knowing how to get money out of this.
Mm-hmm.
For example, how much will I sell this at? Yes?
Mm-hmm.
Not just cooking. Right now we can cook like this, but how will I sell it?
Also commercializing.
Commercializing,
your
yes.
Skill. Okay.
My skill, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So we do cost for this. If you go to a hotel, there's like this hot cadre snapper sell for you at 2,500.
Mm-hmm.
So how did you come to that 2,500?
Mm-hmm.
That's the question.
Mm-hmm.
Now you do the cost from down to up.
Mm-hmm. So sort of like you was also a story of you were mentored.
I was mentored well.
Held your hand.
Yes, held my hand.
Uh-huh.
That's somebody's Chef Emmanuel Aluda,
mm-hmm,
who really supported me well in terms of knowing how to do the kitchen management,
mm-hmm,
knowing how to like almost everything about hospitality.
Mm-hmm.
Right now I'm able to come in front and show what I can do,
mm-hmm,
and how I can do it, and how I can teach other people to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Not only about me, at times not about me, but what about the other guys,
mm-hmm,
who are there? If I was mentored well, I should mentor somebody else,
mm-hmm,
well.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Did you start at Parkin by Radisson?
No. I started way
stay
far.
There,
okay. No.
Parkin,
actually, it's been a journey. But for Parkin right now, I'm having 1 year, 6 months.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
All right.
But it's a journey, you see? So the more you have more skills, the more,
mm-hmm,
get more people to...
Mm-hmm. I've had several chefs here, some starters, some who've been here longer.
Yes.
And what do you think is the biggest challenge? Because many get into the industry, but very few that you would find still standing 16 years later like yourself. So
yes.
What happens apo katikati?
You see, well, the moment, actually for most of my students, I always tell them, don't be pushed to do something which is not on your heart.
Mm-hmm.
You see, for you doing what you're doing right now,
yeah,
is something which you love.
Yeah.
Anything you love, you'll never let it fail. That is true?
Mm, it's true.
So for me, I love cooking. And anything concerning cooking, I must be keen to know what is going on about cooking.
Mm.
I was telling you, even if you wake me up at 1 at night.
Cook.
I'll start, what am I cooking? What am I cooking?
I start somewhere. Okay.
But still, I'll cook something out of that.
Mm-hmm.
Even if I was having some sleep or something,
mm-hmm,
but I'll still cook that food.
Mm-hmm.
So it means what is driving me to do that is the passion which I'm having for food.
Mm-hmm.
If we don't have passion for this, is the time now somebody has 2 years and is like, hey, your cousin, I chokesha. Because it's tiresome. Getting here at job, like right now, I came for this show. After the show, now I start my shift.
Yeah.
That's around from 11 until 11 in the evening.
Mm-hmm.
You see?
Oh, 11 to 11.
11 to 11, you see?
Uh-huh.
Now, if it's not passion which is driving me to do that, will I even achieve?
You will not.
I will not achieve.
Maybe I think it cuts across in every career.
Yes.
If you get in it for the money, you will be disappointed.
You will be disappointed. Yes, that's
the money will follow. You do what you do
what
the best
you do.
Way you can.
Yes.
The money will follow.
The money will just come.
Yeah.
From nowhere. It'll be like, chef, come. Maybe this event. Do it.
All right.
You get some small things. Eh? Thank you.
Yeah. So as you do that, tell us are some of the, as you plate, because up on your shida,
up on your shida,
cook well, and then
to know
bona ni exaggerating. Yeah.
So
assume it's a class.
So is this a class? Eh?
You told me you train.
Yes. So I'm having a puree, beetroot puree,
mm-hmm,
or we call it beet paint. So it's just basically a puree from the beetroot. Okay. So, presentation goes hand in hand with creativity.
Mm-hmm.
Art is an art, actually. So I'm using a compi here. to do my presentation.
Okay. Kuna kombi ya chakula.
Yeah, chakula. So this is the comp. Eh?
All right.
So, you see, for you, how will you do it if I give you the comp?
I don't know. I'm assuming this is supposed to draw some lines somewhere.
Draw some lines somewhere.
Yeah.
So how will you draw it?
No, it depends on the creativity. With
the, yes, now
what
that's the point.
Want.
What
that's,
you want,
yeah.
Yes.
As long as it's appealing.
Yes, so for mine?
For me, I'll sort of like, I don't know, try something circular.
Something circular, yes.
Yeah, but let me see what you're doing.
So for mine, I'm doing like this.
Oh, okay. It still works.
Still works?
But I was right on the lines, eh?
Yes, you were like...
Okay.
You were right, yes. So
you see how you've achieved the paint, the red, you know, with the,
exactly,
something edible.
Something edible. Mm. So after that, we do our rings here.
Mm-hmm.
Then, okay, this is how it goes, eh? You should know how you're plating from your head to the plate. So you plate from your mind first.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever you plate on your mind, now you put on practice.
Okay.
Yes.
So you already have the
idea. So I already have the idea in my head. So I'm trying to put it on my plate.
Okay.
Hey. So easy.
Did you know kupika ni ngumu hivyo?
It's not hard. So for my roshti, I can either serve like this,
uh-huh,
or I cut it into half. See, it's easy.
Yeah.
So I'm not trying to use my knife so that somebody can at home can just do it easily.
Mm-hmm.
You see, I want to show how easy it is. You can see?
Mm-hmm.
It's already, you can see?
Mm-hmm.
It's like a spaghetti.
In a chana tree.
So I just put there. Then our carrot. Just put one there. What's your name, Itwaji? Ay.
Where?
Imeenda.
Imeenda.
Imeenda. Ijarudi. So our rings, put around there.
There you go.
Okay. Easy.
Love the layers, and now it's coming along.
Yes.
And then our fish there now.
Our fish.
Hey, awesome. There you go.
See? Then after that, I have a plant here called Naphorium. Wanaitanga matawi ya bush.
Oh. Okay.
So you put there. You see now the creativity. Just coming
that makes
from.
It different.
Yeah?
No wonder you can make this at home, but again, if you're not ready to go through all this trouble.
No, it's not a must you do like how the chef is doing over here. So always our knee goes with.
Looks good.
Always it goes with lemon.
Looks
just put
really
one,
good.
One lemon.
What's like your best, your signature meal?
My signature meal?
Uh-huh.
Salmon.
That's what you make ile unajulikana nayo. Maybe chef akona.
For salmon, I always, actually, I think I can present everything.
Uh-huh.
For presentation, I always, I feel
this
like.
It's ready or bado kidogo?
No, it's ready.
Oh, okay.
I'm just doing our sauce here, just a bit.
Awesome.
Tomato sauce.
Awesome.
There it goes.
Awesome.
See?
And then you present. I love it, don't you? And we've made everything here as you watch. So this side looks more inviting. You want me to do the
honors? You're supposed to do the honor.
Hey, dig in. Nime dig in leo, mapema sana. Let me try this. Wanasemanga try and have a bite of everything.
Yes.
But I don't know whether I'll manage that now. Wacha kwanza tuanze isamaki. Mm-hmm.
Mm. Mm. How is it?
Mm, I love it. Good job.
Now, is it going to be your Sunday best?
Mm. You know, you're testing a lure with fish. Eh?
Yes.
Me deliver.
Me deliver.
Oh, now let me. The waru pancake. Mm. Najaribu nisiharibu presentation.
You can.
Eh?
It's all yours now.
Najaribu nisiharibu your presentation. Aha. Awesome. I love it.
You love it?
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. All right.
So it's easy. We've just done from scratch.
Mm-hmm.
I think You can just do it at home, anytime, Sunday-based.
Breakfast, lunch?
Breakfast, lunch, or even dinner. Mm-hmm. Yes.
All right. So I want to know more about your journey.
Yes.
You were telling me that over time you have learned to always keep your skills fresh, learning new things every day.
Yes.
But I'm sure you've observed even how the industry has changed over the years.
True.
What are some of the things that you find as key highlights? Like, unaona nini inabadilika, even in terms of what the consumers are demanding for, yeah, in terms of their preferences? Yeah.
Well, first thing which really has changed is the technology.
Mm. The right food now is really good, by the way.
See, when I feel too comfortable.
I can't wait.
Just eat.
Yeah.
So technology has really changed the hospitality industry. There are so many things which have come up, like different companies, different ovens, different ways of cooking. This is just like a new challenge of life. If you sit comfortably and just do how the old era, which they were doing, if you do it right now, they'll be like, hey, chef, bwana hiki tulikuwa mwaka gani bwana? You get it?
Mm-hmm.
So you have to move with how the technology is moving.
All right.
If they're using this type of oven, you try your best to know how that oven is being done. Because right now, we don't even boil things nowadays with sufurias. We just do it from oven.
Mm-hmm.
You just put on the oven, you steam, you give it time. It goes pa-pa-pa-pa-pa, it gives you some alarm.
Mm-hmm.
The other new technology which even brings you, you can even connect the oven with your Wi-Fi, with your phone.
Mm-hmm. You kind of control it remotely.
Remotely. Not much, you be there. It gives you a signal that your food is ready, something's mm-hmm. ready, just come and pick it out.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All right.
So you see, those are the few things which are coming up.
Mm-hmm.
We must always be like, pa-pa-pa-pa, you know, like, this is going there, let me do this, let me learn this, let me do this, let me go this way.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All right. The young chefs who probably could be watching and they want to get to where you are.
Yes.
We've seen a lot of content creation these days, and some are just trying to cut a niche for themselves in the market, and they are not breaking even.
Yes.
I don't know what advice you'd have for such. Like, how do you, you know, break even in this industry?
So I always tell people, keep it simple. Simplicity is art to perfection.
Mm-hmm.
So keep it simple. Don't try to do something which you know personally cannot do it. You get it?
Mm-hmm.
Just be you. Know what you want to do. Like I was telling you, if I'm doing my plating like this, I do from my mind first. I already have a thought of how I'm going to plate it before I do it. Some people, they usually take plain paper. You draw what you want to do it. You draw, you try and see, is it coming up? Then you put it on your plate.
Mm-hmm.
But
you actually sometimes draw.
You draw on a paper.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
You know it's that artistic. It must
be artistic.
Uh-huh.
So you just draw on your plate, you draw like a plain paper, you draw a plate like this, a circular round gray, you say round gray plate. This I'm going to put my puree, you put there. This I'm going to put my fish. This I'm going to put this and this there.
Mm-hmm.
But while you're focusing on doing plating, focus too on the flavors of the item you're cooking. Make sure it's nice. The color is there. It's not just like a plain color. It's just red.
Mm-hmm.
Let it have some mm-hmm. color blendings.
Mm-hmm.
Setting up things, it must go still from your mind. You can see how I've set my things here.
Mm-hmm.
It goes with still passion and knowing what you're doing. It's like a self-driven thing. Yes.
Mm-hmm. All right. What's like your worst moment ever since you started this? Was there like a day or a season that you felt kind of like this was my lowest, and how did you bounce back from that?
My lowest was
or that difficult client or whatever.
Okay. One thing I can remember was 2022. We had, it was a Christmas actually, funny enough, but the guests came 6,000. So we only have 3 kitchen, and we tried our best to serve all those 3 guests. And it's not like a buffet,
uh-huh.
it's just an a la carte.
Uh-huh.
So they pay from the menu, you present, you give out.
Mm-hmm.
So you can imagine you are 10 people and you have 6,000 guests to serve.
Mm-hmm.
See, the pressure is too much.
It's real, yeah.
So whatever, okay, you have ideas, but you can't bring that time. Things are running down,
mm-hmm.
guests are there waiting for the food, they are bugging, some children are there crying, they want chips. You have to struggle for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
I remember I was even like pay huyu mtoto chips kwanza, mm-hmm. tutamlipisha baadaye.
At least so that they can.
They're just crying there like, yeah. Oh, this small kid crying here.
Yeah.
Just mpe chips kwanza nyamazi, tumtafutie chakula baadaye.
Yeah, yeah.
But there are so many, yeah, at least the guest is coming to the other side of the kitchen, but
It was a good problem to have.
But a bad problem at the same time, because most of them were not satisfied, because it's just like an ambush.
Mm,
yes.
Mm.
But all in all, so I feel like it was a good experience to me and a bad too. Because okay, it's like a good, because at the end of the day, I learned how to handle pressure of many people, make sure that all of them they have some food to eat, even if it will take more hours. But still, they had something to eat, mm-hmm, on that table.
Mm-hmm.
So it was a big challenge on myself. I started this career. For those years, I've done it. But still, I still remember that day, because it was not easy.
It was on not. My, you were under pressure. Not,
was
you
under,
had to. You had to like think on your feet.
On your feet. Mm. True.
All right. Yes. All right. So, any like kitchen experiment gone wrong? Sometime you wanted to try something and then you ended up surprising yourself.
Yes. Okay. For like something like salt, for salt, it always goes like this and you go like this. But one thing I've ever done something wrong on making a bad.
Have you ever made a bunt of a ring?
Yes, I've done. Obvious. I've done. Everyone has done,
yeah?
That. Forget. But now that one comes when you forget something.
Ah, okay.
So you're like, oh, nimesahau kitu kwa fry. Ukina kutoa hivi, ooh.
It's all over the place.
Just the vaca.
Okay, okay.
And that is a cost which has umekata your cost.
All right. Yeah. You know, it's actually interesting also to always know where you got the passion from as a man. As in, was it your mother? Was it like, was it from the family? Or it's just something you decided one day that you want to do?
Okay, for me, it's a very long story, though I'll just try to make
summarize.
It summarize. I had a very humble background, whereby both my parents died, so I had to stay with my sister Sophia. So Sophia was, we were struggling in life. So the only way she could do ni to make tutengeze bajia kwa barabara to pate do yaku to sustain home. So through that niko tupika ni bajia niko class 6 hapo. So by class 7 nikaanza kupika mandazi. Kuza ma kufanya nini ndio zile ma roma ngumu like zile za kitambo. Yes, yeah, we had to like,
okay.
The life was so hard,
mapema.
Like kujituma mapema, yeah.
Uh-huh.
So tukaanza kupika hizo mandazi na Mike More tukaanza kuuza kwa maduka 5 bob hizo.
Mm-hmm.
So while I studied my high school, I had to save some small money out of that small job, kulipwa 30 bob 100. So unajinyima una save at least ndio usome secondary. So secondary nika still nilikuwa nafanya semi hii kazi tu ya mandazi.
Mm-hmm.
But you see, like, it's the food which has made me go to the high school.
Mm-hmm.
Now from high school I got an opportunity to do those mjengo.
Mm-hmm.
So kujua na wasee tu nikaanza kufanya kazi kwa hizi bakery za keki.
Mm-hmm.
So nikafanya kazi kwa hiyo bakery nikafanya hiyo time yangu ya high school. So natoka shule nafanya bakery, naenda shule, like ilikuwa tu ni tafuta pesa ya kulipa school fees.
Mm-hmm.
So after that, nikifika form 4, at least nilikuwa nishapata basic poa ya hizo makeki. So nalipo kitu kama 7,000, mm-hmm, at least per month.
Mm-hmm.
So nikaanza kuisave. Nikisema,
sikia hiyo, 7,000 per month. Oh, unadharau kazi. Back then it was a lot of money.
No, it was not a lot. Kwani nilikuwa mbali aje? Kwa mbali hiyo.
Ama nafanya una kazi.
Mimi si mzee sana bwana. Wale vile jamaa niangalia. Sina ndevu bwana. Eh, so anyways. So kumaliza high school nikarudi kwa ile bakery. So nimemaliza shule, so at least nilikuwa nimepata mwalimu target, akaniambia at least you're form 4 ndio nipate pesa sasa ni join college.
Mm.
Nilikuwa nimeanza kuuza mandazi kwa shule.
Mm-hmm.
So ile tea break ile sana.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, so sasa najipikia home. See, I already have the skill, so I can cook good mandazi. Tunauzia studio 5 bob, so nafinya kwa bagi yangu packet kama 20.
Mm-hmm.
Naingia na shule. So nikiingia shule mwalimu anajua mimi bora nisitope. Eh, bora nitoke tu top 7.
Ah, ulikuwa top 7.
Top 7 hapo, yeah. Teremka chini cheze tu hapo. Nikitoka niende 8 na biashara inakatwa. So akaniambia ukianza hiyo kazi biashara nakata.
Uh-huh.
So at least nika maintain until actually thank to chef to Kamakia, who's my principal, really supported me well,
yeah,
until I finished my high school.
Mm-hmm.
So after that, now I went back after the school nikamaliza nikatoka na grade at least poa. nikatoka nikasema like nime save do kiasi but sasa college nataka pesa mzuri. So I had to go back to the industry sasa ya kuya bakery. So I do the bakery kwanza kupika hizo kutengeneza makeki.
Nika save
do sasa ya college. Until another day somebody came and told me, Moha, by the way, kuna kashule kanaitwa PC Kinyanjui somewhere. Just go there. Uongee na wewe mwalimu mwezi kwa sana ni mwalimu mpoa. So I went there nikapatana na secretary, she was so okay, I know the she was like this, but now due to that hizo moods, she chased me away like
una
kuja 7000 no you 7000 ndio uko kauko kando kwanza
una 7k college
so ningefanyaje hiyo
serious
sasa sasa hiyo ndio nimepata kama hiyo nyingine nime at least nimeweka kando niseme at least nione
yeah
kaniambia wewe kauko kando kwanza
we just went to start
just
in everything in life just start
start, yes.
Start.
So nikaanza tu polepole hivyo then she was like wewe endaka hapo kando so siku enda nikakaa tu hapo kando like almost like 4 hours. So, hey, this guy is serious. Now, kuja na kwa Kiremi huko. So, that's the HOD. So, when there, Kiremi was like, how much do you have? Kwa mbea 7. Nothing else. Tafuta kama ni 12. Kwa mbea 7. Nalapata yo 12 lakini. Ndaka kwanza. Haka nambia, there's no problem. Tafanya hivi.
Kwanza shule.
Leta I 7. Nikupatia uniform. Klasi yako ndo ile pali imeanza.
Was it now ye ya kupika?
Ya kupika sasa, yes, yes.
So, you knew what you wanted.
I already saw... Since I already had the bajia, the keki.
Kuna experience.
So siku anajua kitu kingine ati sijui nifanye, sijui steamer, sijui ni just food. Now I went and joined the class for food and beverage, production management. Now I started there. So from there, the mwalimu was there, Mr. Kalingu, was like, this guy has passion. So every weekend, we could go for some gig. I be given like 4,000, 5,000. You see, now I'm getting good money out of that.
Yeah,
within 1 month. Yeah, within 1 month, I already paid my school fees.
Ah, awesome.
And that's how I joined and started my career slowly, going to the
club. I've hosted you so many times on this show, and you've never had enough time for you
True.
To give me that story.
True.
Self-made, yeah?
Self-made.
The story of one young man who just, mtu mwenye amejijenga.
Amejijenga mwenye.
From scratch.
Yes.
Yeah, no, the mandazi guy now anapikia hoteli kubwa Nairobi. See God, hapa ni wapi?
Yes, yeah, so.
That was so inspirational.
So see, my first attachment is when I met Chef Emmanuel.
Uh-huh.
And he really saw that this guy can do this.
Uh-huh.
So let me mentor this guy.
Mentor this guy. Yes. All right. Tumemaliza. Uliniletea zawadi by the way.
Yes.
We wind up na waambie watu unapatikana wapi. Ulisema wakupatie picha ya Kenya
wamefika. Yes.
They don't know where to tag you,
yes.
Where to find you. So as we wind up, ukinipea zawadi yangu.
Yes. So unanipatia kama kupigwa picha.
You present. Ona zawadi ameniletea. Just when I say I want to
reduce the weight.
Start cutting it. I was telling him, that's when I say I'm changing my ways. Boom. He shows up and brings me the things I'm trying to stay away from. But thank you so much.
So, Kashata.
Just watch out to cheat leo. Tuna cheat tu leo.
Cheat the body.
Okay.
So you can get me from Facebook, Chef Moha, I'm Chef Moha Shaib. For my Facebook, for my Instagram, 254 Chef Moha, 254 Chef Moha. At my LinkedIn, Chef Mohamud. You'll just get all my things there. Please visit Pakin Beradison. We have more than this. Make sure you come, taste our foods, taste our nice new menu. Come see our culinary arts there. You'll really enjoy, and it's affordable. We have some more events. Come and do your birthday there. Do all your baby showers, meetings,
Thank you.
And other stuff. Yeah? Kindly welcome at Pakin Beradison.
Thank you so much. For this great, so many rudisha nyuma. Nilikuwa nimeacha hizi vitu.
Ulikuwa umeacha hivi hako.
Nilikuwa nimeacha hizi vitu, but we, ile utamu iko hapa. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, guys, for watching. We hope we've made your time worth the while. Bedhe kufanya show na unakula, jo.
Kofiti.
All right, so that is how we wind it up. I hope you've had a lovely experience with us in the kitchen. This is what we've made. Show it up on YouTube shortly so you can make this for yourself, for your loved one. We are getting into the holiday season, actually to Meanza. So do something different. Be creative. You know, add something into your cooking skills. My name is Safina Chingoma. It's been a pleasure.